We have had cars vandalized, we've had people robbed, even journalists were attacked today. And some of those people who are conducting or carrying out these attacks were people demonstrating in your name. Do you take your responsibility for those attacks?
Not at all. What happened today? Today was supposed to be a peaceful demonstration. Our constitution and Article 1 says that the power in the Republic of Kenya, sovereignty that is in the hand of the people of Kenya. They can either exercise it directly or through their elected leaders. So we were actually invoking that article in our constitution, read together with Article 37 of our constitution, which gives our people the right to picket, right to present petitions, right to demonstrate, so long as it is peaceful.
But there are those who will look at the pictures of protesters holding stones, hurling them in the direction of the police and even at some citizens. And then they'll say the constitution provides for people who are peaceful and unarmed. Would you not say that you're stretching the meaning of peaceful demonstrations if we do see protesters carrying stones?
There's what is called offensive violence, and this is what is called defensive violence. The two are not the same. The police went and basically sealed the residences. People could not come out. They are throwing tear gas at the people within their compounds. So people therefore now came out to defend themselves. They wanted to get out. And that's why they were actually throwing stones at the police. So those two kind of violence are not the same.
Do you see a situation where Raila Odinga and President William Ruto sit down at a table to talk this out instead of the chaos you're seeing on the streets?
I've said that there are conditions which must be fulfilled before we can have any meaningful discussions. Mr. Ruto must first respect multi-party democracy. Secondly, he must agree that the server will be opened so that we can examine what is in the server. Okay? Thirdly, he must stop the reconstitution of the Electoral Commission before we can sit down and talk. And of course, finally, he must agree to address jointly with us the issue of the cost of living of our people.